श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा। गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णु गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुसाक्षात् परब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। द टॉपिक ऑफ इन्वेस्टिगेशन इज डेल्ट विथ एट डिफरेंट लेवल्स डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द स्टूडेंट हु इज एड्रेस्ड। फॉर एग्जाम्पल, when the Lord started telling about the reality in the seventh chapter, there he told this basic principle, mattaha parataram nanyat kinchidasti dhananjaya mai sarvamidam protam sutre maniganaiva. What is the meaning of absolute is defined in this verse of seventh chapter. The teacher says, what is the meaning of absolute? Mattaha parataram. Absolute is that which does not have a cause. Second, mattaha parataram anyat. Absolute is that which does not have any comparison. And kinchit. So mattaha parataram na anyat na kinchit. Kinchit means the effect. So absolute is that which neither has the cause nor the effect nor there is any comparison possible. See how scientifically it is said. Now, this supreme reality that I am, what is the position of the relative world then? So he tells, mai sarvamidam protam sutre maniganaiva. This whole world is like the beads of gold put together by the thread of gold to make a garland or a necklace. Now be very attentive. The gold is the thread which is a support for the appearance of the garland or the rosary or the necklace. And the beads are also nothing but the gold. So the thread is the gold and the beads which are kept together, supported, they are also gold. So the same gold is appearing in two ways. One is the support, the thread, and other is the supported, the beads. Meaning, the support and supported has no meaning because both of them are gold. In the same manner, the teacher tells that this is the meaning of the absolute. So, from the point of the absolute, relative has no meaning. Second, relative becomes meaningful only because of the absolute. Make it very clear in your understanding. Then spiritual practice is a fun. It is not a torture. Like, you know, these days, children, one day I was somewhere and Swamiji, can you teach us Sanskrit? I said, yes, I can teach you. But will it be a fun? So they want to learn Sanskrit, they want to learn mathematics, they want to learn the various subjects, but it should not be a torture, it should be a fun, then we can learn. That's why the world is becoming funny every day. So why not bring the same principle of fun in our spiritual life? And this is the technique. So again I repeat, from the absolute standpoint, relative has no meaning. Relative becomes meaningful because of the absolute. Okay, now I, the relative being, go to the Lord. Oh Lord, please help me. I am suffering so much. From the absolute point of view, no meaning. You go on crying. Or another relative standpoint, that, you know, Lord, by your grace, I am very happy and I have done so many good work and I have done this much of charity. The Lord, your charity has no meaning from his point of view. This point he said in the fifth chapter. Nadatte kasyachit papam nachaivam sukratam vibhu ajnane navrutam jnanam tena muhyanti jantavaha. The Lord is not interested in our sinful acts or the meritorious deeds. See? Therefore, now this point is brought out first time in Bhagavad Gita by the teacher in the seventh chapter. That, hey Arjun, you want to understand the absolute, and unless you recognize the absolute that you are, you will suffer, suffer, suffer. There is no choice, no option. There is only one way to be absolutely happy, is to be absolute. Because being and absolute are not two. Wherever there is relativity, there is misery. Wherever there is a division, there is misery. Therefore, see, a simple example will make this point clear. There is an object called as Rasagulla, and there is a person called as a Bengali, me. As long as the Rasagulla remains away from me, so how the Rasagulla is recognized? As an object of enjoyment which is existing. Rasagulla is. Now, I, who is the knower or the taster of the Rasagulla, is away from it. Be very attentive. Now what is happening? Existence is separated from the consciousness. Then, third step in our experiment. We take that Rasagulla and land it on our tongue. The moment we land it on our tongue, our mouth and eyes, everything closes. Now what has happened? The division, the difference, the separateness, the otherness between the existence and the knowledge is zero. Wherever the knowledge and existence is one, that experience is called as bliss. See? Satyam jnanam anantam brahma yo veda nihitam guhayam parame vyoman soshnute sarvan kamansah. Taittiriya Upanishad tells, the moment the division between consciousness and the existence is obliterated, removed, cancelled, and when the consciousness and existence merge into one experience, that one experience is called as bliss. Dekho Maharaj, what will happen then? Mind will disappear. Mind is the culprit which is creating the difference between the knower and the known. So, to bring this absolute reality to our cognition, the teacher gave 15 examples in the 7th chapter of Gita. So he started, Rasoham apsu kaunteya prabhasmi shashi surayoho pranavaha sarva vedeshu shabdakhe paurusham drsu. Arjun, do you want to see the absolute yoga? What is that yoga? Yoga is rasaha aham apsu kaunteya. Hey Kunti Putra Arjun, the taste, T-A-S-T-E, taste is the essence of water. We are not talking about the water H2O. That is a chemical thing. H2O is not water. That because of which the experience of taste takes place, that is called as the essence of water. So when we are having temperature, when our tongue is dry, there is no element of water, that time we are not able to taste anything. So the water that we see, the essence behind that water is the taste. Therefore, shabda, sparsha, rupa, rasa, gandha. So rasa is the yoga, the atma, the essence, the absolute of the water. Now, what is the vibhuti? The glory of that rasa is different kinds of tastes. So this point was inaugurated in the 7th chapter. Rasoham apsu kaunteya prabhasmi shashi suryayoho. I am the essence of light. Essence of light is rupa tanmatra. That because of which all the forms are possible. Now see, we are all seeing the different forms. Why? Because of the presence of light. If there is pitch darkness, we will not be able to perceive the differences on account of the forms. So this rupa tanmatra, that essence because of which the forms are established, is called as the essence of the sun and the moon. Now to understand this subtle thing is not possible for everybody. Then Bhagwan started telling something more deep, and Arjuna was asking about that. But you know, we have heard that, you know, when somebody dies in Uttarayan, he goes to heaven. Somebody dies in Dakshinayan, he goes to hell. Therefore, when our Bhishma Acharya ji was on the arrow deathbed, he was holding on his life. He did not want to die in the Dakshinayan. He wanted to die in the Uttarayan. So what about that? The different types of gatis. Now that secondary topic was brought out in the 8th chapter. Please remember one basic thing. First, living as body. Second, living as the jiva. And third, recognizing as the non-dual reality that we are. Living as the body is Dharma Shastra. Living as the jiva is yoga and upasana. And recognizing the non-dual reality is the Brahmatmaikya Bodha, the ultimate. And this ultimate has to be attained. All other things are secondary. See, we have heard many stories in various Puranas that there was one particular king, he has done a lot of yajna, and if he completes the 100 yajnas, he becomes the prominent candidate for the position of the Indra, the king of the gods. Now what the Indra does? He sends the Madan Kumaran party and tries to create lot of problems so that his last yajna is destroyed and then he cannot come and take my position. What is the difference between a child fighting for a chocolate and Indra fighting for the seat? No difference. See, very, very clear. The Jiva Bhava, whether you are a mosquito or a Indra, is the same thing, no difference. So unless we get out of it, we have nowhere walked the spiritual path. Therefore, to recognize this reality, the teacher in this 10th chapter gives us still simpler method. And a simpler method is, we are not able to directly dive deep to the essence of the reality. We are not able to do it. But we are able to see the plurality. Now the teacher takes that as a support which we can understand. See, there is one story. There was one Mahatma. He was giving everyday satsanga and people used to come and see. And there used to be one illiterate man, illiterate boy you can call, who used to trade his buffaloes for grazing. And buffaloes are sitting there and he is sitting in the Mahatma. No, nothing, absolute quiet. One day, that Mahatma gave an example. If you suppose love a buffalo, see, any example is given by the Mahatmas according to the requirement of the totality, the Lord decides, not the Mahatma. So, suppose you love a buffalo, that day the Mahatma gave the example. Then start seeing God in that buffalo. You will see God. And that was enough for that illiterate boy who was trading the buffaloes. From next day onward, he stopped coming for the satsang. And this boy was so deeply involved that the buffalo started behaving like God for him. See the power of this bhavana. Bhavana is not ordinary thing. So, the power of bhavana, you can see places like, you know, the autobiography of a yogi, there you see all these things. When that Swami Yogananda was, you know, looking at the wound of that particular sister or somebody, and he became so much involved that the wound appeared on his body. This is the power of bhavana. So, when he did that bhavana, he started seeing the God in that buffalo, and the Panditji said, "Hey, what are you doing? You told me buffalo is the God, so I got the God. Why should I come for your satsang?" So, it is easier for the people to suspect God in that what we love. Therefore, Matru Devo Bhava, Pitru Devo Bhava, Acharya Devo Bhava, Atithi Devo Bhava, stage by stage. Now, this is given in this 10th chapter now. He says, Aham Atma Gudakesha Sarva Bhutashe Sthitaha Aham Adishcha Madhyancha Bhutanamanta Evacha. I am the Atma, the essence of everything and being. And therefore, if that reality is so abundantly the essence of our being, why do we behave as a relative individual and suffer the pangs of relativity? Discover your own essential self. About this, there was one event in Bhagavat Mahapuran. One king doesn't have the children, so many wives, standards format. And thereafter, then one Mahatma comes, he gives him fruits and he gets a child, and then the child is growing. So the king and the mother and the child are growing together. The other queens are jealous, ladies can do nothing but that. So they were very much jealous about that other people. And then they planned a strategy, and the child was given poison, the child dies, and then the mother and the father, the king, are crying away. And like suddenly by a pop, our Naradji comes with the same Rishi, and then he said, "Don't worry, I'll call that Jiva." The Jiva comes and he is told, "Enter the body and again enjoy the world. Why you have gone?" Now the Jiva says, "What body? What parents? Who is crying? I have had so many pairs of parents. If I cry for every pair of parents, I will have no time to smile. No, but they are crying. I say, that is their wisdom. What can I do? Please remember, never, never become miserable because of anybody. Don't be sentimental. Don't write emails. You know, emails are emotional blackmails. You don't do that. Never get corrupted by relativity for any reason. Everybody comes in this world to wash away his own leanings and get out of the world. We have no business to become miserable because of anybody in this world. So, aham adischa badhyancha bhutanamanta evacha. After having focused attention on the essence of everyone, including ourselves, now the teacher is telling us according to our requirement. Adityanam aham Vishnuhu Jyotisham Raviramshuman Marichir Marutamasmi Nakshatranam aham Shashi. Now all the things which are hanging in the space, you look at them and see the God there. See, for example, Adityanam aham Vishnuhu. So there are different types of Aditya. Now, I will not be able to tell you the stories of all 74 episodes here. But one thing I can tell you, Aditya, there were two things, one Diti and Aditi. And the Diti's children are called as Daitya, and the Aditi's children are called as Aditya. They have got a common husband. So the Daitya and Aditya, they have got same father. But their wives, that means their parents, mothers were different. Diti means the one who is believing in division, duality, relativity. Aditya, the one who is believing in the non-dual existence. And therefore, Adityas are called as gods and Daityas are called as Rakshasas. So whenever we talk about duality and separateness, we are the demons. And when we talk about oneness in spite of the duality, we are divine. And therefore, Adityanam, among the children of Aditi, I am the Vishnu, because Bhagwan Vamana took avatar as the child of this Aditi, and then he has taken care of that Bali, who became so powerful, and then he became very big and pushed him to the to America. See, I'm not joking, Baba, every time. America, according to our scriptures, is the Patala Lok. And therefore, there all the rules, regulation, thinking is so perverted, which we cannot understand. So, Adityanam aham Vishnu Jyotisham Raviramshuman. And among the bright objects, I am the sun. Then Marichir Marutamasmi. And among the 49 Marudganas, I am the Marichi. And Nakshatranam aham Shashi, among the Nakshatras, I am the moon. Vedanam Samavedosmi, among the Vedas, I am the Samaveda. Samaveda is music oriented. And the meaning of the words become most beautiful when it is associated with the music. So, Vedanam Samavedosmi, Devanam Asmi Vasavaha, among the gods, I am the Indra, Vasavaha means Indra. Then Indriyanam Manaschasmi, among the senses, I am the mind. Without the mind, senses become important, they cannot understand anything. Therefore, many times we sit here and Babaji is talking and we don't hear anything because the mind is engaged somewhere else. So Indriyanam Manaschasmi, Bhutanam Asmi Chetana, among the beings, I am the consciousness. See? In this manner, he is giving so many examples. Now, wherever, whatever place you are, you will find an excuse to contemplate on the divine presence. See? Now, when I am looking at you, I can look from two standpoints. One is the relative standpoint, second is the absolute standpoint. Relative standpoint is what? We are all different from each other. The criteria of differences, Some are men, some are women. Some are intelligent, some are very intelligent. What can I say? Some are beautiful, some are awful. Or awfully beautiful, let us say this. So many differences. But what is the common factor? Common factor, we are all suffering because of you. So the common factor is that we are all conscious being. So bhutanam asmi chetana. In this manner, we are given this training. So when we look at a person, earlier habit of seeing the differences. I'll tell you an example how this goes deep in our system. I was once going by scooter in Rajasthan, from Udaipur to Jaipur by scooter. A new Hamara Bajaj, and somewhere on the way, like a Hindi cinema, it just stopped going, but I didn't fall because it was not a Hindi cinema. I didn't fall. And then I was not able to make it move. So it was such a problem. What is happening? And I didn't know what is inside the bonnet. So I parked the car, the scooter there, and sitting there, oh Lord, send somebody to take care of Baba. I don't know what to do. And after a few minutes, one again scooter was coming, Lambretta, old type, and two people were sitting on that. And then they stopped. He asked, where are you from? I said, from Bombay. Are Bombay ya hai? Yes, I'm from Bombay. Immediately friends. And then they somehow, whatever they did, it started. Went a long way and came back. When they went long way, I said, my God, scooter gone now. Old left ear, new taken away. They came back and they say, now go slow because the ring is expanded because of too much of heating of that, you know, piston. Go slow, everything will be all right. Up to this time, no problem. God, you are sent. Really, you are really great. Bhagwan ki jai ho. Then, out of courtesy, I said, by the way, what's your name? Oh, my name is Abdul Qadir. Oh, Musalman. Immediately, the mind starts getting into differences. See? But if our attention is on this conscious reality, then man, woman, animal, plant, everything is secondary because all of them are there because of this one conscious principle. So when we train ourselves to see that conscious reality, then alone we are really practicing spiritual life, and that is real scientific. So when I go as a most scientifically oriented person to the doctor to get my heart operated, what is that I see? What is his gotra? Do I see the gotra of that doctor? No. Is he also a kachchi like I am a kachchi? No? Is he, what are the two types of kachchis I recently came across? One is Pushkarna Kachchi na Lohana Kachchi. See? All these differences are meaningless when I am talking about a doctor operating the heart in the perfect manner, in the same manner. When we are living our life on the foundation of scientific understanding, the differences born on account of anything have to be secondary. So, bhutanam asmi chetana, rudranam shankarashchasmi, vittesho yaksha rakshasam. Among the rudras, I am the shankara. Rudra means the one who makes us cry. There are many rudraganas, ekadasha rudra, 11 of them. You know, in our scriptures it is said that there are 33 crores of gods. So, the original word is 33 koti. Now, koti does not mean crore. It is, you know, a wrong translation. Koti means classes. So, there are 33 classes where different types of expressions are possible. So there are 12 of them are the sons, Dvadasha Aditya, 11 are the Rudras, 8 are the Vasus, 2 are the Ashwini Kumar, probably they have become 33, find out, I don't remember. So these are the 33 kinds of gods which are maintaining the whole creation. So among them, among the Rudra who makes us cry is Shankarashchasmi. Friends, be very attentive. Shankara means what? The one who does good to us is Shankara. Now that tragedy, that misery because of which we are crying, that tragedy and misery can become Lord Shiva, Shankara, if we turn our life's flow from the relativity to the absolute. See, Arjuna Vishada Yogo Nam. Had not there been a tragedy, a confusion on the battlefield in the mind of Arjun, there would never have been the birth of Bhagavad Gita. So, whenever there is something terrible happening in our life, please remember the Lord is extremely careful for our welfare. See, you know, our Swami used to give an example. He said, when the child is extremely dirty, what the mother does, pulls the child, puts on the lap, takes the soap and rubs it. The child is crying, let him cry. And if the dirt is so terrible that the child, the mother has to take the sandpaper and rub it on, that time the child will cry more. But the mother won't listen. And when cleaned, washed, properly powdered and dressed, that time the child does not have even a time to say, Mom, thank you. Because before that itself, he has entered the slumber of bliss. Isn't it? In the same manner, every difficulty that we have in our life, it is the best thing that can happen to us. If you remember, I told you long time back, one Urdu sher said by a great Sufi saint, Ye wahi darde dil hai jo unko paata hai. That means it is the tragedies in our life which reminds us of the God. Ye wahi darde dil hai jo unko paata hai, khuda bhala kare unka jo dil dukhata hai. How important it is. This is what is called here, that Rudranam Shankarashchasmi Vittesho Yaksha Rakshasam. So among the Yakshas who are the Ministry of Finance, there I am the Kuber, the Finance Minister. Vittesho Yaksha Rakshasam Vasunam Pavakashchasmi. So among the most purifying things, Vasus, I am the Pavaka Vasu, Meruhu Shikhiranamaham, among the all the tall mountains, I am the Meru, Meru Parvat, the center of the total universe. I am going a little fast, everything I won't be able to tell you, but this is the technique. So whenever we are looking at the mountains, it is the Meru, and the moment you think of the Meru, immediately you become totally introvert and the mind goes straight into your Sahasrara. पुरोदसाम च मुख्यम माम विद्धि पार्थ सना बृहस्पतिम सेनानी नाम हम स्कंदः सरसामस्मि सागरः. सो अमंग द पुरोहित पंडित जीज आई एम द बृहस्पति एंड अमंग द बेस्ट वॉरियर्स और द चीफ्टन्स आई एम द स्कंद सरसामस्मि सागरः एंड अमंग ऑल द बिग एक्युमुलेशंस ऑफ वाटर आई एम द ओशन. महर्षी नाम भृगुरहम अमंग द ग्रेट महर्षीज आई एम द भृगु. गिराम अस्मि एकम अक्षरम एंड इन द स्पीच आई एम द वन सिलेबल कॉल्ड एज द ओम एंड यज्ञानाम जप यज्ञोस्मि स्थावराणाम हिमालयः. यज्ञ, देर आर मेनी ऑफ देम, And among them, I am the Japa Yajna. Because by this Japa Yajna, it is easier to contemplate and focus the mind on the source where from the word is uttered. Even if you try this, it is so simple to discard the relativity and get recognized and established in the absolute. For example, when you do this, this is called as Japa technique. Never do japa with a hurry. Ram 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 Ram. Ram will get confused whether you are called me Ram or Ram Jethmalani. Either original Ram or a Sindhi Ram. So, take every name of the Lord with all sincerity, with complete involvement. Shri Ram. At this, just see where from the Shri begins, where the Ra is existing, and where the Ma goes back. Shri Ram. Shri Ram. When you do this extremely sincerely, without any disturbance, you will be able to clearly experience, like we clearly experience, the chair is different from the clothes are different from my body, the body is different from the mic. That distinct clarity. The relativity has nothing to do with me, the absolute origin of the total sound. Yajnanam japayajnosmi. Try this. Then the meaning of the absolute is recognized. What is that meaning? That the sound Sri Rama is because of me, I am not because of the sound. So, in the presence of the sound of Sri Rama, I is present, and in the absence of the sound of Sri Rama, I is present. And therefore, presence and absence of the Sri Rama is relative to each other, but the absolute is present in both the present and the absence of everything that is experienced in this world. Hold on to this absolute reality. See, the waking and the dream is recognized as existing. The deep sleep is recognized as total absence. But the waking and dream does not add anything to me, and the deep sleep does not take away anything from me. On the contrary, it is because of me alone, the waking experience of the gross world, the dream experience of the thought world, and the experience of absence in the deep sleep, they are possible. So this absolute me is supporting the relative experiences of waking, dream, and deep sleep. Recognize this and play the game of life. Yajnanam japayajnosmi sthavaranam himalayaha. Those which are the most very well established mountains, I am the Himalaya. See, by God's grace, we have moved so many places throughout the world. But the experience that you get when you go to Himalaya is totally different. You go to Alps. You go to various mountains in the whole world. You do not get that experience what you get in Himalayas. You go to various rivers, Mississippi, and you go to another big rivers like Nile and all that. But the moment you say Ganges and look at her, there is a total metamorphosis of her thinking process. Therefore, that which is reminding us of the Lord is holy. So, sthavaranam himalayah, ashvattaha, sarvavrukshanam, devarshinam cha naradaha. So, among the trees, I am the ashvattha vruksha. Now here I'll give you little explanation. See how deeply scientific is every thought. Ashwatha is a fig tree. The fig tree comes in every religion. And the fig tree has a speciality. If you take any tree, it can grow either from the seeds or from the cutting. But when it comes to fig tree, means the Ashwatha, means either the peepal tree or the Vatavruksha, banyan tree, the peculiarity is the fruits are eaten by the birds. And then the seeds of the fruit, they are swallowed by the birds. And then those seeds are as if processed in the GI tract, in the gastrointestinal tract of that bird, and then it is excreted in the excreta of the bird. And when that excreta falls anywhere, then only the plant can grow out of the seed which has come in contact with the Chaitanya, the consciousness of that particular bird. So Ashwatha is one of the similes given to this whole world of relativity. So what is relativity? Relativity is an impossible wedlock between the matter and consciousness. See, in absolute matter there is no problem. In absolute consciousness there is no problem. When the matter and the consciousness come together, a phenomena called as the mind is born. And it is the mind which is called as the ego and creates the comparison, the relativity. And therefore, all the spiritual practices, reverting the mind back to consciousness, reverting the prana back to consciousness, and thereafter start living as consciousness through the body. Start living as a consciousness through the mind. Start living as consciousness through the prana. This understanding and experience is called as total realization. Ashwatthaha sarva vrukshanam. So when we see so many trees, this Ashwatha vruksha reminds us of the divinity. But when we are very awfully modern, educated, illiterate, in one house that mother was telling me about her son. Swamiji, I don't know what to do with my son. I said, don't do anything, leave him, delete him from your head. You know what he says? I said, I don't know. He says, why worship only the tulasi? Why not worship cactus? Vrukshanam cactus osmi. Why only tulasi plant? See, in upasana, this is kind of upasana, where you are trained. And when the training is common, then we can grow together in that atmosphere. That way God is everywhere, but are we able to see Him? No. So this is a training. If you are able to see the God in the cactus, you are really tremendously grown up spiritually. So, Ashwattaha sarvavrukshanam devarshinam cha naradaha among the devarshi, I am the narada. Gandharvanam chitraratha among the gandharvas, I am the chitraratha. Siddhanam kapilo munihi among all the siddha, I am the kapila muni who has given the sankhya shastra. And the basis of the sankhya shastra is developed the Patanjala yoga shastra. And in the Patanjala yoga shastra, when we are able to do the sayama in the different manners, we develop all the vibhutis, all the powers, the ashta siddhi. Everything is possible when you follow this path of the Kapila Muni and practice according to Patanjali Yoga Darshan. Uchchai Sarva Samashvanam Vidhi Mam Amrutodbhavam. When the Kshirasagar, the milky ocean, was churned, so many things came out. That time one horse also came, and his name was Uchchai Sarva, which was given to Indra. And Airavatam Gajendranam Naranam Cha Naradipam. And among the elephants, I am the Airavata, which is again owned by Indra. Naranam Cha Naradipam. Among the human being, I am the king. Now, here one pause, then we go ahead. See, This is worth understanding for all of us. Who is a king? A person who is able to rule or control or attract or be the head of a huge number of people. He is called as a king. Now we have no business to compare with them. If somebody is really able to do that, he definitely has something great in him. Therefore, it is our bounden duty that any leader in our country or in any society is, that leader definitely has something great because of which he has come to that position. And we have no business to condemn them. But when we condemn them, we have not understood the spiritual path at all. If you see, the other day somebody asked me, Swamiji, why don't you get, you know, tell these politicians something? I said, look here, I am telling you, are you listening to me? No. Do you think they will listen to me? And second thing, I have no business to go in their job. If I want to play politics, I should give up this and get into the political field with complete involvement. Standing from a distance and talking the great good or bad things about politician is not the scientific way of spiritual life. So, naranam cha naradhipam, ayudhanam aham vajram, dhenunam asmika madhu. So, among the various kinds of missiles, I am the vajra. Vajra is the most powerful missile ever known to the humanity. So, vajram. And dhenu naam asmi kamadhuk, among the cows I am the kamadhenu. The kamadhenu cow was with Vasishtha Rishi. And then our Vishwamitra was a king. He wanted that. He said, why should you have a Babaji? It should be for the king. And then there was a fight between Vasishtha and the Vishwamitra. And this is how whenever you have got something good, you always end up in a trouble. So, prajanaschasmi kandarbaha sarpanamasmi vasukihi. So, among the most attracting one, I am the kandarpa, and sarpanam, among the snakes, I am the vasuki, which was used for churning the milky ocean. Anantaschasmi naganam varuno yadasamaham. And among the nagas, I am the ananta on which Lord Vishnu is sleeping. Varunaha yadasamaham, and I am the varuna. And then pitrunam aryamaschasmi yamaha sayyamatamaham. Among the pitrus, I am the aryama, and sayyamatam, those who are well controlled, controllers, I am the yama, the lord of death. Pralladaschasmi daityanam. Among the daityas, the destroying forces, I am the prallada who was the uniting force. And kalaha kalayatamasmi. And in all the changes, that factor which is responsible for all the changes, that unchanging principle, kala, I am. Mruganam cha mrugendroham. Among the animals, I am the lion. Vainati yascha pakshinam. Among the birds, I am the garuda. Pavanaha pavatamasmi ramaha shastra bhutamaham. So among the wielders of the shastra, I am the Rama. Jashanam makarashchasmi srotasamasmi janavi. Among the best rivers, I am the Janavi, the Gangaji, Sarganam adirantascha madhyam chaivaham Arjuna. And the most important, adhyatma vidya vidyanam. The real knowledge is the knowledge of the self. Why? Because when I know physics, chemistry, computer science, cooking, washing, this does not free me from the miseries of life. See? You may be a psychiatrist. That doesn't mean you will not go mad. You may be an oncologist. That doesn't mean that you will not have the cancer problem. You may be a heart specialist. That doesn't mean that you will not heart attack, you will not have a heart attack. But if you are a man and a gynecologist, then you are saved. He won't have any obstetric problems. So, adhyatma vidya vidyanam. Among all the knowledges, only the knowledge of this absolute reality is the knowledge worth, because this alone can liberate us from all the problems of relativity. See, this whole chapter is devoted only to this. We live in the relative world, but never forget our absolute status. If this one thing goes deep in our understanding, you will see everything will be played like an actor on a stage. The actor never forgets that he is a miserable husband of a terrible wife. He never forgets that. But when there he is on the stage, suddenly he becomes Shivaji Maharaj. And when he goes home, then the wife tells, "You are not on the stage, okay? Sabji kato." So Chhatrapati Shivaji takes out the sword and starts cutting the See? So let us play the game of life. Let us not become serious. There is nothing in this world which should disbalance us because of success or failure. It is a common thing happening. Once you catch this point, the absolute is the one which is immune to changes, and the relativity is the one which is the foundation of changes. Once you go into that again and again, again and again, then adhyatma vidya vidyanam. Now see, what is the meaning of adhyatma vidya? When something bad happens in our life, we go for counseling to the counselor or the psychiatrist. Now what a psychiatrist does? He maintains you. See? He will never like to. There is not a single case which is cured by a psychiatrist. Not possible. But when you go with the same problem to a spiritual master, whosoever he or she may be, and there what is done is only this. Change your angle to look at the problems of your life. And then we come to know that all the problems are only because we are buried under the illusion of relativity as if it is real. When you understand the illusion as an illusion, you are out of the illusion. See? And when you take the illusion as the reality, you succumb to the pangs of that illusion. Therefore, adhyatma vidya vidyanam vadaha pravadatam aham. And among the arguments, argumentative people, I am the ability to put forward our views in such a manner that we do not destroy, but we unite together. That creative argumentativeness is my presence, the Lord says. Aksharanam akarosmi dvandvaha samasikasya cha. Now he is taking the grammar. Aksharanam akarosmi. In the Sanskrit language, and for that purpose, every language, there are alphabets. And all the alphabets, if you study our Sanskrit language, you will really enjoy. There it is said. The first sound that comes out of our mouth without any efforts is a akar. Therefore, in every language, A is the first alphabet. Whether you call A, whether you call A, or whether you call Alaf, or you call Alpha, doesn't matter. So, Aksharanam Akarosmi. So, this original A is modified by the usage of the tongue, and that is why it is called as U. And the last syllable that is chanted by the human mouth is the labial, and that is the M. Pa, pha, ba, bha, ma. And therefore from a, u, ma together become the om. So even the beginning of the om is from the a. And this is what the teacher says, aksharanam akarosmi. And what is the akshara? Akshara is the one which does not get destroyed. You use the word ra, then a, and ma and a becomes Rama. And when you tear up that paper, nothing happens to the alphabets. Similarly, the same ra can be used also for writing Ravana. So when the ra is used for Rama and the ra is used for Ravana, nothing happens to that ra. It is immutable. It is the absolute. Again and again contemplate on this. Contemplate. So absolute is the one which is supporting the relative. Rama and Ravana, they are in relation to each other, enemies of each other. But the Ra and the Ma, these are only the Akshara, they are the absolute. And they are never corrupted, never destroyed. Akshara Nama Karosmi, Dvandvaha Samasikasya cha. Among the Samasas and the Dvandva, where both the letters are given equal importance, Mrityu Sarvaharaschaham, I am the death who is taking away everything from us. When you look at the death as the divine grace, there is nothing in this world that can disturb us. Mrityuhu sarvaharascha, sarvahara, the one who is taking away everything. So that mrityu, that death I am, and udbhavascha bhavishyatam, and I am the beginning of the future. Because unless the present ends, the future cannot begin. Bhurat sama tatha samnam gayatri chandasamaham. And among the various chandas, I am the Gayatri Chanda. Masana margashirshoham. Among the months, I am the margashirsha. And Rutu nam kusumakaraha. And among the various seasons, I am the spring. Dyutam chalayatamasmi. Among the people who are able to manipulate, I am the ability to manipulate. Tejas tejasvi namaham. And I am the brightness among the bright people. Jayosmi vyavasayosmi sattvam sattvatamaham. And the goodness among the good people I am. Vrishni nam vasudevosmi. Among all the people born in the Vrishni kula, among all the Yadavas, I am the Vasudeva Sri Krishna. And Pandavanam Dhananjaya. Among the Pandavas, I am Dhananjaya, the Arjun. Muni nam apyaham vyasaha. And among the various munis, I am the Vyasa who is responsible for our total spiritual literature. Kavi naam Ushana Kavihi. Among the Kavis, there was a great Ushana Kavi. I can't go in detail. Dandaha damayatam asmi niti rasmi jagishatam. And I am the authority by which we can rule the world. And niti rasmi jagishatam. And I am the principle because of which we succeed in our life. Maunam chaivasmi guhyanam. And among all the secrets, I am the silence. Therefore, the more we practice silence, the Lord is expressing through us. Words create relativity. Good, bad, important, unimportant, nice, not nice. Silence is homogeneous, absolute. And whether the word is Sri Rama or Bevakuf, both these words start from the silence. They are maintained in the silence and they go back to the silence. So this silence is the reality behind all the sounds. Therefore, Maunam Chaivasmi Guhyanam. Among the most secret things in life is the silence. Therefore, friends, please, remember this. The more we focus attention on this silence, you are migrating, walking towards the absolute. There was one amma who used to come for my lectures somewhere in East or somewhere. And morning, evening, both lectures she will come. But she will never talk a word. So I was very happy. I like people when they don't talk. Very happy. And then I was called to their house for food. And when I went there, it was non-stop. Non-stop. And after that, she said, Swamiji, you are again and again referring Akhandananji Maharaj in your lecture. How are you connected? I said, why you should worry about our corrections? No, because you know he is my guru. So are we guru bhai bahan? I said, you call any names, I don't care. Then you know what he told me? He told me the highest spiritual practice is Maunam. So what I do? In the evening when there is a sunset, I start my Maunam. And in the morning, unless I complete my puja, my niyam, it takes about 9-10 o'clock. Till then I am observing Maunam. So how do you like my sadhana? I said, now because I am very closely associated with Swamiji, I will add something more. You continue your Maun 24 hours. It's very, very important. The lesser we talk, the lesser is the relativity created. In the silence, it is absolute. That is why the more you talk, the more mistakes. The less you talk, less mistake. Don't you talk, no mistakes. So Maunam Chaivasmi Guyanam Jnanam Jnanavatamaham. Among the wise or the knowledgeable people, I am the knowledge. And Yachapi Sarva Bhutanam Bijam Tad Aham Arjuna. Na Tadasti Vina Yasyan Maya Bhutam Characharam. And now the teacher is telling that Yachapi Sarvabhutanam Bijam Tad Aham Arjunam. I am the seed of the total creation. Oh, you are the seed of total creation. Like we take the seed, let us say a gram, and we sow it, and slowly it is a dicotyledonous plant. So the two things come out, and then one goes up, one goes down, and the one goes which down, that becomes the root, up it becomes the plant, and in that process the seed is destroyed. So Lord, you are gone? Because you are the seed of the total world. Therefore, Yachapi Sarva Bhutanam Bijam Tad Aham Arjunam. Now here, please remember, what is the meaning of Bij? This is very subtle thought which comes in Bhagavat Mahapuran. See, when the power is with the powerful, when the Shakti is with the Shaktiman, and this Shakti or the power is not corrupting the Shaktiman or the powerful, then it is the pure consciousness. Now, second thing, when this powerful, the Shaktiman, is corrupted because of the power, those corruptions are called as the seeds. And because of these seeds, the differences take place. Now, to understand, take an example. When our clothes are washed and squeezed and forgotten and they get dried that way, thereafter when you open your lungi or whatever shirt it is full of crease. Now what is that crease? Is that crease something other than the cloth? No. And yet it gives ugliness. In the same manner, pure consciousness with the bija impressions of relativity is mind. So, what the Lord says, that as much absolute I am, so much the relative also I am. And therefore, don't differentiate between the absolute and the relative. Don't differentiate between the gold and the golden ornaments. See? This thought is so beautifully brought out by Sant Gyaneshwar in his book, Amrita Anubhav, where he says, why run away from the relativity? Why not have the capital of non-duality kept intact? Invest it in the game of life and earn the dividends of duality. What is wrong in that? See the beauty. And therefore, now we are coming towards the end of this chapter. Therefore, ultimate knowledge is what? live as an absolute being and play the game of relativity. And this is what Bhagwan Krishna has done and demonstrated in his life. See? This is the meaning of avikampa yoga, etam vibhutim yogam cha. Recognition of the absolute as one's being, yoga. And recognition of the totality or the plurality as the glory of this reality is the vibhuti. So he who thus recognizes the absolute self that he is and the relative world is nothing but his own expansion, he alone can be firmly rooted and never disturbed by anything in this world. That is called as avikampa yoga. So, yachapi sarvabhutana bijam tadam arjuna na tadasti vina yasyan maya bhuta characharam. Maya vina, without me, nothing can ever exist in this world, whether it is living or the inert things. And therefore, Arjun, nantosti mama divyanam vibhutinam parantapa. Hey parantapa, hey Arjun, mama divyanam vibhutinam antaha nasti. There is no end to my glory. If the ocean has to talk about the glory of his waves, he will have to come to the same conclusion. Look here. If I want to talk about every wave of mine, it is not possible because they are ananta, they are unending. In the same manner, there is no end to my glory. And therefore, esha tuddeshata prokto vibhute vistaromaya. And therefore, whatever I told you, this is what maximum I can tell. However, I can conclude. What is the conclusion? Yad yad vibhuti matsatvam srimat urjitameva tat tadeva avagachatvam mama tejonsha sambhavam. Be very attentive. Wherever you see anything great, recognize the divine presence in that greatness. If somebody is a good player, the divinity is manifesting. The other day, I received one email. When these our cricket fellows won and they got so much of money and all that, that time I received one email. In that email, that person has written, see, our jawans are dying on the battlefield. Our people are fighting the battle against the terrorists. And how much they are paid? And these fellows, they go and hit the ball for nowhere. And they are getting so much of money paid. What is this kind of thing going on? This kind of thinking is a perverted thinking. Please remember this. Everything in this world has its own place. It is not that everybody has to go and take a gun in the hand and start fighting. Then who will do the fighting inside the house? God has to maintain the balance. Therefore, yadyat vibhutimat, wherever you see something great, srimat urjitamevava. Now what will happen thereafter? You will start practicing and seeing divinity in every way. One or two examples I'll tell you. When you see somebody elder than you, his age is something great as regards you are concerned. So see the divinity in all elderly people, whatever may be their age. If somebody is richer than you wealth-wise, then see the wealth associated with that man as the divine grace, and therefore respect them. If somebody has got some good quality, somebody is a good singer, somebody is a good dancer, somebody is a good player, doesn't matter what he has, but that special quality, ability is only the demonstration of the divinity in action. In short, find out an excuse how to respect everybody one way or the other. When you start respecting everybody and everything in this world, then you have understood the scientific way of living according to the 10th chapter of Bhagavad Gita. And that society where respect is divorce, it is an arrogant society of selfishness. So, athava bahunaitena kim nyatena tavarjunam vishtabhyahamidam krishnam ekamshena stito jagat. What more to tell you, Arjun? This whole glory of mind is but just a little an iota of my existence. I am far more than this. See, when we have lived in a small village all through our life, maximum what we can think is only village level. But when a person who has been trotting around the whole world and he has seen so many things, and when somebody goes on talking the glory of his own village, so what this man will think? Yes, that's good, that's good. But there is something much more than the glory of the Lord. Meaning what? The glory of the Lord is much more than what we can comprehend. Therefore, never be satisfied by your spiritual practice. Discover every day new technique to discover His presence in your life. The day when we become dull-witted, God is everywhere, now what is there today, what is the need of meditation, it's okay, what is the need of taking the Lord's name, I have taken so many days, I think now I have come to a point where there is no inspiration to live because I know everything about God. This kind of contentment to live the spiritual practice is most detrimental. A spiritual man is always inspired and he is living life and not living death. Therefore, Bhagwan says that what to talk about my glory? What you have seen me? Like a son of a Devaki growing as a son of the Yashoda and then moved from here and there, that alone is not me. I am far much beyond that. And thus go beyond the relativity and the absolute and come to the point where the mouth becomes silent, the mind becomes thought-free, the consciousness is dissolved, and the absolute existence where the relativity and absolute both becomes redundant, that abode is the absolute. Hold on to this. And when we thus get established in this knowledge, then alone we will be able to live our life most beautifully, without regrets and without arrogance. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnaat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. ॐ शांति 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 ही हरि ही ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः हरि ही ओम. प्लीज वेट फॉर 2 मिनट्स. दिस लेक्चर सीरीज इज एज यू नो द बोर्ड इज ऑल्सो रिटन इज ऑन अकाउंट ऑफ द गुड नेचर्ड चिल्ड्रन दैट बेलाबेन एंड मुलजी भाई हैड एंड देयर